and welcome to Ellen Ruth Soap. I'm Ellen, and today I'm making a soap using this fragrance from Be Scented. It's called Leaves, and it's a type of, I don't know who makes this originally, but it's wonderful. Oh my word, let me read the scent description for this fabulous fragrance. It says, crisp red apple, golden nectar, and warm clove and spice. Oh, isn't that wonderful? It sounds wonderful. Let me see if it says, oh, it's a Bath and Body Works dupe. That's what it is. Okay, so that's the fragrance today. And even though here in Tennessee, I'm still in the middle of hot, hot, hot summer weather, I've got to start thinking about fall, my fall lineup of soap. So Leaves is what we're doing today. It's going to get me in the mood for fall because it just really has, it evokes, the scent really evokes like outside on a fall day raking leaves and maybe an cup of apple cider. I don't know, it kind of makes me think like that. So let's talk about the colors that we're going to use today. Thinking fall colors, I'm going to use Goldenrod Mica from Be Scented mixed with a little bit of Tangerine Mica from Be Scented. And I'm going to dull this down, not dull it down, but mute it down a little with some of my Red Vibrance from Nurture Soap. And this is one of my favorite reds. It's gorgeous. And so I will put a touch of this in the orange to sort of rust it up a little. And then this color. So those are going to be some of the colors we're going to play with. This fragrance has good reviews that it doesn't cause acceleration or any kind of problems like that. And no discoloration. It doesn't have vanillin. And it smells amazing. I'm excited to do this. I did make in a previous video, let me grab some here and show you, a whole bunch of leaf embeds, a whole bunch of them. So those are going down on top to represent my leaves for this leaves soap. Okay, so this is going to be an aloe vera soap today because it just made me think of trees and plants, and aloe vera is a plant, and that's just where my mind went. So aloe vera is going in this soap today, and I haven't really figured out, I might do some layering in the body of the soap. I'm still thinking about how I want this to look, but definitely going to use those embeds down on top. And so let me get everything pulled together. I will formulate a plan as I get my oils measured and my aloe vera lye prepped and ready to go. I'll know what we're doing by the time we get there, I promise. Let's come back and make some aloe vera leaves inspired soap. All right, we're back and it's additives time. And let me just tell you, I have all my colors split off. I'm gonna be adding a green color in here too, just cause I wanted to. Cause you know when the leaves change, sometimes there's a little green left. So I've got them all, sorry about the close, pre-dispersed in a little distilled water. I've got my buckets off to the side and I'm gonna be splitting this into those four containers with the colors. The fragrance is already in here. Oh, it smells so nice. What an inviting, just wonderful scent. Time for the dry ingredients. Let's get them in here. We've got colloidal oats. I'm gonna do 2 tablespoons of colloidal oats, 2 tablespoons of kale and clay, and I'm gonna let this anchor in with the fragrance in the oils as my lye and aloe solution cools, and then we'll be back when we're ready to get rolling. All right, it's time to add the aloe vera lye solution, and I do have a game plan. I am going to do layers, but I want a breakthrough. So I'm gonna mix this to a nice trace and then I'll pour the colors, and I don't mind if it breaks through a little on each layer, but I kinda wanna stack them. That's what I'm thinking about doing. So here's the aloe vera lye solution. What I do is 50% distilled water and 50% aloe vera juice, and I get it in big 1 gallon jugs and I keep it in the refrigerator so it's cold when I pour it in here. To the liquid, I dissolve 1 tablespoon of cane sugar, actually 2 tablespoons of cane sugar, dissolve that in there, put my silk fibers on the top, pour my lye crystals over that and let it heat up and melt the silk, and that's what's going on. And then I add sodium lactate after it's all mixed together and started cooling, and the sodium lactate helps harden the bar up a little quicker. It helps it unmold smoother from the mold. So there's a lot going on in these little pots and I talk about it, but I get so many questions. One of the questions I get asked is, does my aloe vera scorch? No, I have never had it scorch. I will put this in the mold, put the lid on and throw a blanket over the top and let it go through gel phase
I've never had an issue with aloe vera juice. That's different than aloe vera gel. If you take the pulp of an aloe plant and blend it up into that beautiful, thick, viscous stuff, you can put that in soap and it's wonderful, but that's not what this is. This is the juice. So just to be sure, I've never had any scorching issues or overheating issues with it. So I get asked that a lot. So there you go. Let's get it blended in here. And I'm just gonna come up to a emulsion and then we'll split our colors and stick blend as needed after we get it all split off. But oh, this fragrance, it's just hitting all the right notes with me. The next day and ta-da! I just think that evokes all the fall vibes, don't you? I am loving it. And this fragrance was a bit of a mover, but very workable. So we'll talk about that later. But right now, let's get in here and see how those layers came out. With the lovely Olga here, and time to get in here, and I am loving how the top came out and those stripes. So happy. So it was very thick. I do have a couple little pockets here that I can easily fill in and take care of those, but let's get in here and see. I'm so glad I didn't want it to completely break through and do like a drop swirl. I really wanted the layers, but I wanted it to sort of sloosh around. And so this soap being thick like that, it was a pretty fast mover, actually helped out. And I think we got what I was going for. Yay! It didn't actually break through, but it kind of pushed it down. I'm so happy with the color scope on these. Oh, this just evokes all the vibes to me. I am loving it. And it smells fabulous today. I'll just say that. So I may have a couple little air pockets. I'll show you how I fill those in, like on the side here. What I do is when I bevel the corners, you can make a little soap dough and then fill in any holes that you have with the soap dough. So I'll show you that when we get there. Let's keep going. I have a feeling there's not gonna be too much excitement here. It kind of just is all gonna be layers like this, but it is fabulous. Oh, this fragrance too is so, definitely is apple-y smelling. But it's like a cider. It's a sweet, but not cloying sweetness, just like a gently sweet apple smell and all the other notes in there. It's just fab. So happy. So for the color blending, so here's what I did. The green, I added a little activated charcoal in there to sort of dull it up. And the yellow, I actually put a touch of the orange in there so it wouldn't be bright. And then the orange, I put a touch of the red in there. Just a touch. When I'm saying like less than an eighth of a teaspoon, just a little to sort of mute it out because I wanted those sort of rusted up fall colors. And I think I got what I was going for. And of course, this fragrance doesn't discolor, so these should remain exactly as we see them today, which makes me happy. Right, next loaf. I tell you, I absolutely love autumn. Even though I personally have really bad allergies, seasonal allergies, and autumn is a very allergy-rich season for me, but it doesn't take away how much I love it. I will put up with my sneezing and sniffling for some autumn weather any day of the week. I love it. I don't know, sweater weather, it just kind of feels cozy to me. It's very nostalgic of my childhood. It just brings out a lot of really positive vibes for me. So how about you? Does fall do that for you? Some people, it's like Christmas time does that, just evokes all. I love Christmas time too. Winter, I don't know what it is, but sometimes, I don't know, autumn just gets me every time. And making these soaps, as I am cutting these, I am in August, in Middle Tennessee when I'm filming this because I'm thinking ahead for fall with soap. You know, you have to factor in the cure time. So it is like 90 plus degrees outside and I'm getting all my fall vibes on, which cracks me up. Sometimes it's a challenge to make soaps that are the season ahead, you know, because you're not really there in your headspace, but it is what it is. Got to factor in the cure time. So I'm loving it. I get a little taste of fall here in the middle of Tennessee summer. Well, thank you so much for joining me today, making these fall-inspired leaves soap. This was fun to make, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. And if you did, please consider hitting that subscribe button, bell for notifications, all that. And if you want day-to-day updates on my soap studio, follow me on Instagram. I'm over there too. So thank you again for joining me today, and I hope that you have a wonderful day. Mm-hmm.